Guys, I've had another request to do a What's in My Backpack video. Now my other backpack is in storage, and I'm using this one for my day hikes. The longest day hike I ever did was 11 miles. Wasn't a big deal. It gave me time to see the sights and just enjoy it better. Now, since I don't have to take tents and hammocks and sleeping bags and pads and all that, what I do take is in this main compartment, I keep my food, some extra clothes, and an air chair. And this is the one, you don't blow it up. Has a big wide mouth on it. You hold it into the wind, move it around, it gets filled up. You roll it closed, and it's an air chair. And the reason why I bring this is we were sitting on a log one time eating our lunch. I didn't know it. I had a big spider crawling up my back. He bit me like 6 times. I never felt it. But within the next week, my back was just full of blisters and everything. I won't go into details. And another time we went to sit on a log, a downed log, to rest, and a snake came out from under it. I decided, instead of sitting on logs, I would rather bring this. Big and bulky, but it is not heavy. Now, I do carry a platypus to drink out of. I find that I am more likely to drink as I walk than if I do having just a bottled water. This is mosquito repellent. It's Johnson's Baby Cream Oil, and it is a natural mosquito repellent. I learned about it years ago. It is better than soaking your clothes in some of the DIT repellents and this does not repel ticks or anything like that. Has an SPF in it. And I find this perfect to use on the trail. In fact, when you start putting it on, you'll realize how many people forget their sunscreen or their mosquito repellent. Bring a flashlight. I've actually got two on me. This one has a crank. I bring this just in because I'm not into checking my batteries all the time, and a day hike you're really not gonna need a flashlight unless you get in late and you just need it to get through the parking lot and things like that. That's all. Skin. Yep. For obvious reasons, blisters, it's for the feet. I found this the best. It's better than tape. It doesn't come off easy. Even if your skin is wet or you get this wet, it'll stay on. This one is not the mist, this is the gel. This stuff hits you. It can burn. I've had to use it only on animals. I've never had any trouble on the trail as far as men or anything like that. I do check the reports on the trails I'm going. I don't know if you watched Shook Emery online. He was in the Linville Gorge. I checked the date on one of his trips. He was there the day after they had found a headless body in the gorge. So, although these trips may look serene and gorgeous on video, and they definitely are, they're very relaxing. You need to be prepared. I usually travel in a group anyways. I don't ever go alone. As you know from my other videos, I'm a concealed weapons carrier. But I do not carry my gun on the trail. It is just too heavy. And I've never had to pull it out and use it ever, so this is really all you're gonna need. Extra glasses. I was on the trail one time and lost a contact lens. And if you can't read your map or read your phone to get out, you'll understand why you're gonna want one of these. Make sure it's up to strength, as in recent prescription strength. Just another smaller flashlight. Be surprised at this one. You know, I'm a retired nurse. It's a diabetic testing kit, also a sugar kit. I was watching another hiking video where a hiker was dehydrated, severely dehydrated, and he was having trouble talking while he was recording. That's also a sign of low sugar. You're out there sweating and everything, you need to test your sugar. This kit's light, it's easy to take with you. Find out you are hypoglycemic, which is low blood sugar, you're going to need sugar, and the best way to do it is really with a liquid. Second best thing is to chew up a piece of sugar candy. Make sure it's not sugar free, and put it sublingual under your tongue, and it'll bounce you back within, gosh, minutes. Toilet paper. When I bring mine, I always bring a towelette, and I try to usually make sure that they are have a antibacterial killer in, so it's not just a baby wipe. Baby wipes don't kill germs. You won't believe how many people I've spent out on the trail that start asking for supplies because they forgot their little bag. More women than men. Water purification tablets. I've never had to use them. I've never run out of water during the day hike. I'm low. I've never run out. These are better and safer and more efficient than just boiling. If you're on a day hike, you don't have time to boil water. Yeah, I mean, you're not there to, wait 20 minutes. You're usually in a group. These are the way to go. Multi-purpose. It's got a set of knives in here, of course. Screwdrivers. Pliers. I'm not gonna open it. You know it. You've seen it. I carry one. Why? If I'm unconscious, you don't know anything about me, you give this to the medical personnel, And this tells what medication I'm allergic to and what medication I am currently taking. Everybody should have one. Is good for looking for ticks in areas that you can't see real well. Getting things out of your eyes, or if, like me, if you have contacts, you're gonna need it. Extra forks I carry with me. On our 11-mile hike that we went on, the last one we went on, we did have to stop for lunch. There's always somebody. I forgot the fork. Medical pack. I have a bee sting relief, some band-aids, antiseptic. I carry one thermometer. It's a disposable thermometer. You just place it under your tongue. Some Advil. This is a Neosporin. I take Advil almost on every hiking trip. I can tell you, as a nurse, you need to take it before you need it. In other words, don't wait till you're hurting before you take it. I've had 6 spinal surgeries, and after I walk about 5 miles, I'll stop and take my Advil. I don't know any hiker that would go without it. Big bandage. You can use this to wrap up an ankle or a knee. for more support. Anything up here that you didn't see today is my food and water, and that's it. Of course, I carry my phone and a little bit of cash. That's it. Unzipped all the way, only unzips to there. And since this is an ASMR video, I hope you enjoyed the sounds that went with it. Thank you all for watching. I hope you have a great night, and I hope you get a chance to get out there and enjoy the outdoors. I am in the warmer state of Texas, and it is rainy, but it's in the high 60s, so this is my kind of hiking weather. Hope you enjoy it wherever you're at. Bye-bye.